Hey guys, it's Alex from 7th Hour Films back again with Doctor Who. Last time on Doctor Who, we had The Caretaker, where the Doctor went undercover as the caretaker of Cole Hill, and much to Clara's dismay. And then there were conflicts when the Doctor realized that Danny Pink was Clara's boyfriend and a soldier, and there were some clashes. They stopped an alien, and then at the end, the Doctor was like, alright, I guess he's okay. And that was that. It was a bit of an awkward episode, honestly, just because, damn, did it get heated, you know? It got intense with the, you know, with how much they were yelling at each other and stuff, so, yeah, it was rough, but meh, it was still good, so, yeah. This is where I say no spoilers in the comments whatsoever, and we might as well head off into episode 7. Here we go. Do I have subs on? I bet I do. No, I don't. Dang it. The moon! In 2049.
The man who normally helps, he's gone. Maybe he's not coming back. In fact, I really don't think he is.
Okay.
We're on our own.
Okay, so, interesting.
An innocent life versus the future of all mankind. We have 45 minutes to decide.
Okay. Decide what? What's happening?
She took your psychic paper. She's been using it as fake ID.
Whoa.
No. To buy white lightning or alcohol pops. You told her that she wasn't special.
Rubbish.
She says that's what sent her off the rails. Doctor, I know. I know. But you say something like that to somebody, it hurts. Especially if you're somebody of her age. Especially if you're you.
Yeah. Stole the
Doctor,
psychic paper, damn.
It can affect her whole life.
You really think it? I'm nothing. I'm not special.
What do you do, Doc? You and your polka dot shirt?
How'd you like to be the first woman on the moon? Is that special enough for you?
Huh.
Yeah,
alright. Okay, now we can do something interesting.
Okay!
Doctor.
You're really getting pressured by a 13-year-old.
About 100 nuclear bombs.
Why are there nuclear bombs on the moon?
We're about to crash into it!
Oh no!
Why didn't you just tell her you didn't
mean
it?
Yeah, right. You had to make this so complicated.
You see, I am a super intelligent alien being who flies in time and space. You gonna shoot me?
This is normal gravity.
Do you know what's wrong with the moon?
It's put on weight.
How can the moon put on weight?
The tides will be so high.
Yeah.
Drown whole cities.
Jeez, yeah.
So what are you doing about it?
Is that what the bombs are for?
One small thing for a thing. One enormous thing for a thingy thing.
Oh, so much for history.
Yeah. There's the first woman on the moon. How about the first Time Lord on the moon? That's cooler.
It's in the process of falling to bits.
The moon is dying. Like that. Oh. Maybe there's parasites on the moon?
Torch, give me the torch. Whatever it is, it's in here.
Yeah. It's whatever made these cobwebs. Ah, I hate that. Just rustling in the background.
I think we'll find your alien.
Ugh.
Back
with
the door! A door!
Here!
Here!
The door's locked!
Come on!
The
power's working! Come on!
Doctor!
It's just a spider!
Stay still!
Gah! Oh no!
Run, we're power, run!
Oh, they're gonna have to leave him.
Gah!
Oh, it's got teeth! What? Oh, what's she using?
Connie kills 99% of all known germs.
Good stuff, Courtney. Just don't try that at home, okay?
You're right.
Okay, thanks.
Why did I just fly? Oh, it's obvious, isn't it? The moon doesn't break up.
How do you know?
Yeah.
Well, because...
Maybe it isn't the moon. Maybe it's a hologram or a big painting or a special effect. Maybe it's a completely different moon.
Yeah, well, maybe time changes.
If the moon fell to bits in 2049, somebody would have mentioned it. It would have come up in conversation. So it doesn't break up. So the world doesn't end. So let's just
Who
get
brings that up in conversation?
No, there are some moments of... It's amniotic fluid. The stuff that life comes from. I gotta go down there.
Doctor.
Back to your shuttle. Get your bombs ready. You, get to the TARDIS. Get safe. Get Courtney safe. I will be back.
What? No, Doctor.
Okay, so this is it. This is what we see in the opening.
I'm bored. When are you coming back?
Run away. What are you doing?
Putting some pictures on Tumblr.
No, Courtney, don't put any photos on Tumblr.
My granny used to put things on Tumblr.
Fucking Tumblr.
But what about the school? Does the secretary have our number?
Oh, I can't. The secretary hates me. She thinks I gave her a packet of Tanner Lady for Secret Santa.
Courtney's posting stuff on Tumblr. Doesn't Matt know where you are?
I don't know. I'm not his story.
Phone. I know what the problem is. Oh, she can't post that. She can't put pictures of me online.
Right? Is...
That lives under the moon?
No.
What?
That doesn't live under the moon. That is the moon.
What the hell are you talking about?
The moon is an egg.
The moon isn't breaking apart. The moon is hatching.
Huh?
It's an egg.
The moon's an egg.
Oh shit, that's really weird.
Utterly beautiful.
Is it a dragon?
How do we kill it?
You don't.
Kill the moon.
Huh.
Kill the moon.
Well, time for him to go off.
Doctor, I'm sorry. I want to come back, okay? I want to help.
Some DVDs on the blue bookshelf. Just stick one into the TARDIS console. That'll bring you to me.
Right.
And make sure you hang on to the console, otherwise the TARDIS will leave you behind.
Okay. Yeah. That makes sense.
Doctor.
With, don't blink. Or just
Doctor,
blink.
What do we do?
I'm sorry, Clara. I can't help you.
Of course you can help.
The Earth is my home, the moon's not my moon. Sorry.
Come on.
What are you doing, man?
Listen, there are moments. Whatever future humanity might have depends upon the choice that is made right here and right now.
He can't decide it.
Who's better qualified?
I don't know, the President of America.
Oh, take something off his plate. He makes far too many decisions anyway.
She.
Oh, good for them. Finally.
She doesn't even...
And you're just gonna stand there?
Absolutely not.
He's leaving.
Some decisions are too important not to make on your own.
Huh.
Doctor!
Wow. You know, I understand where he's coming from, but... But at the same time, this doesn't seem like the Doctor.
If you think... We should kill the creature. Turn your lights off.
Ooh. Okay.
What do you think? Good night, Earth.
You're only letting half the Earth decide, though. Who knows? They could be asleep. Oh, I don't know, man. Would I really put my faith in humanity like that? I don't know. We're not that great. Well, that is a good chunk of the Earth, but... Oh, shit. Oh! People are turning their lights off. Which one did that mean? Did that mean kill it? Oh, shit.
You can't!
Sorry, girls.
Four.
See you on the other side.
Oh.
Two.
Hey.
Aborted! Oh!
1, 2, 3, into the TARDIS.
What's happening?
Let's go and have a look, shall we?
It's gonna hatch. He knew this would happen, didn't he?
Bloody idiot. Could you please let us see what's happening?
He popped into the future, didn't he? Oh, shit. That is so crazy to see.
The chick flies away and the eggshell disintegrates. Harmless.
Wow.
It laid a new egg. It's beautiful.
Wow, already?
It's beautiful.
That's what we call a new moon.
New moon.
You can be the first woman on that.
I told you I've got gray areas.
Yeah, I noticed. Tell me what your new doctor has. I'll smack you so hard you regenerate.
Oh, shit.
It wasn't my decision to make. I told you.
Yeah, well, why'd you do it? Was it for Courtney? Was that it?
Well, she really is something special now, isn't she? First woman on the moon, saved the Earth from itself, and rather bizarrely, she becomes the President of the United States. She met this bloke called Blinifer.
Do you know what? Shut up! I am so sick of listening to you!
Oh, shit.
Pathetic. No, no, no. It was patronizing. That was you. Patting us on the back saying, oh, you're big enough to go to the shops by yourself now. Go on, toddle along.
Well, that was me allowing you to make a choice about your own future.
That was me
respecting you.
Oh my god, really? Was it? Yeah, well, respected is not how I feel.
Oh, damn.
You can clear off, get back in your lonely bloody TARDIS, and you don't come back.
Damn.
You go a long way away.
Damn. That makes a lot of sense that she would feel that way. That is not what he expected.
It happened, didn't it?
Well, he was wrong, wasn't he?
Okay.
Wasn't he?
She did tell him.
What do you think?
I think I've seen this look before.
No, you haven't. This is new for me.
Yeah, not on your face, on mine.
What did you do?
Yeah.
I'm done. It's over. I'm finished with him, and I told him that.
What you're not.
For? Why don't you believe me?
Because you're still angry. You never finish with anyone while they can still make you angry.
Hmm.
Where did you get to become so wise?
Same way as anyone else. I had a really bad day.
Huh. Bet you he killed someone. That was him going too far, I bet. Whoa, that was intense, man. That was really intense. Man, that's crazy too. Her, at the end there, I like her, you know, looking at that moon because, yeah, she lives in the past. So that is still the moon, still incubating. Wow, that was a hell of an episode. That might be my favorite episode so far of this season. That was really, really, really good, actually. And probably the most interested I've been in any of these episodes. Alrighty. I mean, seriously, like, that was a really, really good episode. Down to the ending where, you know, where we get something different with Clara, you know, what you would expect, you know? Yeah, and this is definitely, I think, the most interested I've been in the episode, you know? Oh my gosh, I don't know, it's this. That was just like, and maybe this is, you know, coming off of last episode, which was okay, and then, you know, prior to that, you know, Time Heist was good. Time Heist was good and pretty standard. Listen was interesting, I will say, and then, you know, Robot of Sherwood and Into the Dalek, you know, going all the way back, like, those were good, but this one I feel like was the most interesting, and honestly, yeah, that one was really, really damn good. It I think so far this is my favorite one of the season. I will say though, the new moon there. How did that new moon work? It was like, oh, it already laid a new egg. that was the size of the egg it was incubating. Like, geez. That's crazy, man. Oh my gosh. I'm going to look at the moon so differently now. Holy crap. Very clever, though. I really like that, you know? Because we already had, you know, we already had the whole thing with the Rachnos where, like, the core of the Earth was the Rachnos ship and all the other rocks, you know, gravitated towards the Rachnos ship and created the Earth. So the idea that the moon is actually an egg that houses a space dragon, that's awesome! I love that idea. That's so cool, honestly, you know? Because it's one of those things where it's like, that is like super high fantasy, you know? That is super crazy high fantasy. And the fact that that could be something that, you know, we have in our world, you know? The moon. That is just awesome, you know? Oh my gosh. Yeah, that was a damn good episode. I really, really enjoyed that. Holy crap. And I even like the conflict at the end with Clara. With, you know, the fact that, yeah, he did push too far. But now, it almost makes me wonder because, you know, they didn't... I was wondering if she was going to look out and see the TARDIS, but she looked out and saw the moon, which was a great shot. But there was nothing of her getting back into the TARDIS or, you know, going and making up with the Doctor or, you know, him apologizing or anything. But... So that makes me wonder, like, next episode, we might... Pretty sure we're not just dropping Clara right here in the middle of the season. So I'm curious, like, okay, what are we doing next time? Like, hell, maybe we'll get a Dr. Light episode. Wouldn't that be really interesting? Actually, yeah, that would be... Or not a Dr. Light, but a Companion Light episode. Where maybe it's just the Doctor going out for one episode, and then, you know, he comes back around to Clara at the end. I don't know. I have no idea, but... Yeah, that was a really... Oh, excuse me. A really damn good episode. And it's also interesting, because it started with kind of a... I don't want to say a dumb premise, but a not a stellar... opening where it's like, you know, oh, Courtney's still here, and, you know, he said that she's not special, and that hurt her feelings, so we gotta do something, so the Doctor is taking her to the moon to be the first woman on the moon. So it's like, okay, so that opening is not that great. Because, you know what it kind of feels like? It feels like, what is it? Nightmare in Silver. Where, you know, the two kids learn that, you know, they figured out that Clara was a time traveler. So they forced the Doctor to take them through time. And, you know, we had Nightmare in Silver. Which I still hold as a fun episode. I know a lot of people hate that episode, but... but I still hold that was a fun episode, aside from the kids who were kind of shitty, but this one, you know, it kind of repeats that, where it's like, oh, well, you know, now we're gonna take the kid through time, and, you know, here's Courtney, who's basically our fill-in for Angie, because we didn't bring those two kids back this season, so yeah, it's like, okay, with that, Courtney honestly is not that bad. Like, she's all right. And then just add on top of that this brilliant episode, you know? This incredible episode. Like, it just works, you know? It all just works out. So, I really enjoy that. But yeah, taking Courtney, the whole thing of, oh, we gotta take Courtney, you know? And it's like, okay. whoop-de-doo, it's Nightmare in Silver. Although, she's really not annoying. I think they used her the way they were supposed to use kids. You know, it's like, okay, kid, you know, they kind of, you know, they get scared on these missions because, you know, the stuff that the doctor does is terrifying. And then it's like, okay, well, you know, they make some jokes about being a kid. You know, in this case, it was posting pictures on Tumblr. Well, 2014, I guess that makes sense, you know? Now, if it was Twitter, the doctor would have really hated it, but apparently he's alright with Tumblr, so. But yeah, that's funny. And I also like when he's like, you can't post pictures of me on Tumblr. So, that was really funny. It makes me wonder if that, I could see that coming back somehow. Like, someone who tracks down the doctor is like, oh yeah? Well, you were on Tumblr. And he's like, I told her not to post pictures of me on Tumblr. So, and then, you know, that also leads to the joke. What's her name? Cast. Lundvik? Lundvik? Is that okay? Lundvik? Yeah. Being like, oh, well, you know, her saying is like, oh, my grandma used to post on Tumblr. It's like, that was really funny. So, I enjoyed that. So, moving more into the notes. I did just write down moon. I like that immediately it's like, okay, we're on the moon. What's the problem? The gravity. You know, the gravity is the problem. I did really enjoy that. That was really interesting. You know, it sets up for an easy, you know, an easy problem. It's like, okay, well, why is the moon so heavy now? So I like that. The whole thing with the nukes was interesting. Now, the only thing is, were they thinking that those nukes would completely vaporize the moon? Or was it... I don't know. They had nukes. They had 100 nuclear weapons, and they went to the moon to use them. Were they thinking that they were going to destroy the moon, you know, vaporize the moon, or, I don't know, they didn't really say what they were going to do up there, you know, just, it was just basically their last-ditch effort, so, but that was interesting, just the use of, the nukes throughout this. We did get more spiders. Again, there is something to do with spiders with the creation of our, you know, planet and satellite, natural satellite. Yeah, I guess, yeah, our satellite really is natural because it's alive. Technically, the moon is organic. So, isn't that great? But yeah, the spiders were interesting, and then them being bacteria was pretty interesting. Although, they didn't actually end up doing too much, I didn't think. So I'm gonna look back a bit, turn on the subs.
The Earth is my home, the moon's not my home.
Let me take it back.
We're gonna be sick. I'm running out of oxygen.
Doctor!
Today's the day, humankind.
Huh.
Where's the TARDIS?
Is it the shuttle? Is it your show channel?
Yes, and he said that she turned up on the wrong side of the planet.
I do like that when it cuts to her in there. When it cuts to her in there, she's just completely fine, still sitting in that chair. It's like, yeah, even though the TARDIS was being thrown around and stuff, you're completely fine in the TARDIS. That's because that's how great the TARDIS is. Which, you know, after these last couple episodes, I'm really getting on board with what they've done with the TARDIS set. You know, adding all the bookshelves and stuff. It's so homely now.
Do you want to share it with class?
Well, I had a little hypothesis. The seismic activity, the surface breaking up, the variable mass, the increase in gravity. Fluid. Scan what's down there.
moon isn't breaking apart. Well, actually, it is breaking apart. Everyone, people got about an hour and a half. But that isn't the problem. It's not infested.
What are they then?
The way he said that, too.
Bacteria.
The way he said that, too, was, it was kind of like Matt Smith. It was like, the moon isn't breaking up. Well, actually, it is breaking up, but that's not the problem. It's like, I don't know, like, I can easily picture Matt Smith saying that, so. Makes me wonder if this was written for Matt Smith, but they reworked it for Capaldi. I could see it, but, eh. So, yeah, they are bacteria. I love this.
That lives under the moon.
No.
What?
That doesn't live under the moon. That is the
moon. What the hell are you talking about?
The moon isn't breaking apart. The moon is hatching.
That's so... The moon's an egg. I love that.
Has it always been an egg?
Yes, for 100 million years or so. Just growing, just getting ready to be born.
That is so crazy because, like, you know, what is like the one constant across human civilization? What is one constant across human civilization that every civilization, every person on Earth shares? It's the view of the moon in the night sky. And the sun, but fuck the sun. It's the moon. So the idea that the moon, we've known for, like he said, 100 million years, that moon is not what we think it is. It is daytime, so I guess the moon's not up there for me. It's somewhere, I don't know. The fact that the moon, the thing that we've all known throughout the existence of humanity, and it's something else, something fuck none of us would have thought, that is, it is a little terrifying. I will admit, it's a little terrifying, but that is so interesting. I really do love that. And the spiders are bacteria. That's the thing, is that, you know, like any bacteria we have on us, excuse me, basically, you know, they, like he says, they are very, very small bacteria on something very, very large, you know? And it's just that humans are the size of that, so that is pretty cool. Okay, I wrote down small moments and big impacts. I'm gonna go listen to that again, where he talks about how things can be different like this, with, like, you know, is the moon there? Huh. Yeah.
Well, because I've been in the future, and the moon is still there, I think.
Yeah.
You know the moon is still there, right?
Maybe it is.
I do like that, you know, it's like, well, you know, I've been to the future, and the moon is still there. Time changes. History can change, you know? Yes, there are fixed points, but it can change, you know? I mean... Go back to, what is it, The Unquiet Dead. You know, Rose was saying, like, well, you know, I'm from 2005. The world can't have ended in 1869 because I was alive there. And the doctor says, shit can change. Time can be rewritten, you know? So, that's the thing. Even if Clara, well, first off, I like that Clara says, you know, well, you would think that if the moon broke up, it would come up in conversation. Who the fuck would talk about that, you know? I mean, maybe, I guess. Like, maybe you would think, okay, Orson Pink maybe would say that, but a lot of shit happens, you know? So, nah.
Maybe it's a hologram, or a big painting, or a special effect. Maybe it's a completely different moon.
Completely different moon, which is what it ended up being.
If the moon fell to bits in 2049, somebody would have mentioned it. It would have come up in conversation, so it doesn't break up. So the world doesn't end, so let's just get in the TARDIS and go!
No, no, there are some moments in time that I simply can't see.
Yeah.
Little moments in which big things are decided.
Yeah.
And this is one of them. Just now, I can't tell what happens to the moon because whatever happens to the moon hasn't been decided yet.
Huh.
And it's going to be decided here and now.
Yeah. So, I mean, this sort of plays into, is the Doctor sort of omnipresent when it comes to time? And that might not be the right word, but you kind of know what I mean. Which, and they also kind of bring this up in the movie, you know, with the Doctor knowing every, you know, like, everyone's history and their future and stuff, which was dumb and weird and they shouldn't have done that. But they drop it, so who cares? But, you know, it's also just, you know, in this series, like, okay, he knows a lot of stuff. He knows a lot of Earth's history. But sometimes there are some things he doesn't really know. Some things that slip his mind or he just never knew, you know? And there are some things that he doesn't know because they haven't been decided yet. This is one of those. So that was very interesting, you know? It really does go into, you know, like, how he operates as a time traveler, where he knows a lot, but not everything, you know? So I like that. Small moments, but big impacts. So that was pretty cool. And then, yeah, the concept of the moon being an egg. That is fucking awesome. I love that idea. That is so amazing. I wrote down the DVD. Yeah, so if you put a DVD into the TARDIS console, the TARDIS will then find it. It will then return to the Doctor. But you have to be sure you're hanging on to the TARDIS console, or else she'll just leave you there. Which, that is what happened in Blink. Where Sally Sparrow, you know, input one of her DVDs into the TARDIS console. It left her and the guy there, and it, you know, trapped all the Weeping Angels. So that is just a thing they can do. I really actually like that. And it's one of those things where it's like, oh, well, why don't you just do that all the time then? It's like, well, who the hell's going to be in the TARDIS to put the DVD in? TARDIS ain't going to do that. TARDIS doesn't give a shit, you know? So I like that. It's like, it's a way for the TARDIS to get to the Doctor, but it's not a thing they're going to be able to use regularly. It only works because there was someone in the TARDIS. So I actually did like that. And then the big thing, the decision. So, okay, when he started going on about the fact that this is a human decision and he can't make the decision for them, you know? Honestly, that reminds me of the Hungry Earth. The Hungry Earth episodes where, you know, the Doctor brought together humans and Silurians in order to talk and negotiate and figure out how they were going to coexist on Earth. But he stayed out of it. He was not a part of those meetings. He watched and he loved it, you know? He loved that he brought them together. But he stayed out. He let Amy, the female scientist and the leader of the Silurians, he let them talk. Because that is for them to do. He cannot interfere as a Time Lord. Because it's not his planet. So this is very much in that same vein, you know? Because it's not, the Earth is not his home planet. It's not his moon. You totally understand why he would back out, you know? It's like, okay, I can't make this decision. Now, the fact that this is life, you know, the fact that this is a life form, I find it odd that he can't, that he wouldn't just completely object to killing an innocent life. That part is a little odd, I will say. Everything with, you know, the decision makes sense, but the thing is, it is still a life form, and the doctor is always, you know, always adamant about making sure that these new life forms, you know, don't just die, you know? He is, you know, that is one thing that he would argue for. Now, granted, maybe that shows you a difference in the 12th Doctor, that the 12th Doctor isn't like that anymore. But I do find it a bit odd that, you know, it's like, okay, well, they might choose to kill this, you know, life form, this innocent life form. And he's like, well, it's your decision. That is a little odd. That is a little odd. You still kind of understand it with everything talking about, you know, this is your decision, this is your planet, your moon, but that I don't think quite works out, but it still works overall. So yeah, he left the decision to them, which, you know, much to Clara's dismay, and then I wanted to see, what was the whole thing about the lights? Because I think I misunderstood it. I think I misunderstood, like, what the lights meant. I know the lights were the decision, but I don't remember which one was which.
Hello. This is the last time we'll be able to speak to you, but you can send us a message. If you think we should kill the
okay.
Creature, turn your lights off. If you think we should take the chance, let it live. Leave your lights on.
Okay.
We'll be able to see.
Okay, so that was it. That I apparently just, I don't know. It kind of slipped my mind in the moment. So, yeah, if they turn their lights off, then they are willing to let the creature die, and everyone turned their lights off. There was fuck no one that left their lights on. Which, at first, I was kind of like, well, you know, this is really only letting half the world decide, because you can't see the other half that's in daytime, you know? But, I mean, it was a good chunk of Europe and Africa, as well as the Americas. It basically meant Asia was out of luck, though. They didn't really get a vote. So, yeah, that was interesting. And they did turn out their lights. They were willing to let this creature die. Which, that's the thing, is, you know, in the reaction I was saying, like, you know, would I put my faith in humanity to decide? And honestly, that's the thing. Humanity probably would decide to do this, unfortunately. Every light went out. But instead, Clara did go against the wishes of, you know, the decision of the Earth, and decided to let the creature live. And that's the thing, is the doctor did have faith that she would do that. So, and yeah, we got a new moon because the creature laid a new egg, which will most likely be there for the next 100 million years. That I thought was a little odd. Well, first off, I do love when you see it happen. Jesus, just seeing that the moon just break apart like that is so crazy.
What's it doing?
It's feeding the sun on itself. It's getting warm. The chick flies away and the eggshell disintegrates.
Yeah.
Harmless.
Did you know?
You made your decision. Humanity made its choice.
No, we ignored humanity.
Well, there you go.
So what happens now? Tell me what happens now.
And I do like the doctor's speech where he says, you know, this is why humans actually went to the stars, because instead of looking down at themselves, for once they looked up and saw something beautiful. And this probably is a change in humanity, because they all decided, hey, you know, whatever's up there, we gotta let it die. But when they look up there and they see it in all its majesty, and they see the thing is harmless. It's harmless, and the shell disintegrated. It probably, you know, incites a change in them, which is pretty cool. And now, the final thing, which is Clara. Skip ahead a bit.
So hard to regenerate.
Yeah.
Nothing. I told you, the gray areas.
Yeah, I noticed. Tell me what your new doctor has. I'll smack you so hard you regenerate.
He didn't know. That is one thing.
I know they don't usually destroy their nests.
Yeah.
Essentially, what I knew was that you would always make the best choice. I have faith that you...
He did suspect. I think that was part of it, is that he suspected, you know, that this egg hatching wouldn't destroy the Earth. So that's why he was okay with letting Clara make the choice. Which, that's the other thing too. It's like, okay, well, why would the doctor be okay with, you know, the possibility of this creature dying, but he had that much faith in Clara?
You would always make the right choice.
Honestly, do you have music playing in your head when you say rubbish like that?
It wasn't my decision to make, I told you.
Yeah, well, why'd you do it? Was it for Courtney? Was that it?
Well, she really is something special now, isn't she? Thus, women on the moon saved the Earth from itself. And rather bizarrely, she becomes the president of the United States. She met this bloke called Blinham.
Do you know what? Shut up. I am so sick of listening to you.
Oh, well, I didn't do it for Courtney. I didn't know what was going to happen. Do you think I'm lying?
I don't know. But if you didn't do it for her, I mean... Do you know what? It was cheap. It was pathetic. No. It was patronizing. That was you. Patting us on the back saying, well, you're big enough to go to the shops by yourself now. Go on, toddle along.
Well, that was me allowing you to make a choice about your own future.
Yeah.
Respecting you.
Oh my God, really? Was it? Yeah, well, respected is not how I feel.
You do completely understand why Clara would feel that way. You know, she views it as more of, you know, this patronizing old man, you know, saying like, oh, well, humanity, you're good enough now, you know? Which is that is the difference between this and the Silurian conference, where, you know, with that, frankly, because the stakes were so much lower, that the Silurian conference worked, because, you know, they looked at it as, okay, we need to make this decision. And he said, you need to make this decision. I cannot be a part of this. This is you, not me. The doctor tried to repeat that here again, but the stakes were just way too high. And Clara feels like, no, you shouldn't have done that. You should have at least helped. Even if she, you know, even if it was their decision, he should have stayed and at least helped, you know, talk it over, you know? At least be a supervisor, you know? Which, granted, even in the Silurian conference, the doctor wasn't a supervisor. He watched. He was a spectator. But at least he was there, you know? Whereas this time, it's like she says, like, okay, you're old enough to go to the shops by yourself, you know? So.
Right, okay.
I nearly didn't press that button. I nearly got it wrong. That was you. My friend making me scared. Making me feel like a bloody idiot.
Language.
Oh, don't you ever tell me to mind my language. Don't you ever tell me to take the stabilizers off my back. And don't you dare lump me in with the rest of all the little humans that you think are so tiny and silly and predictable. Walk our earth, Doctor. You breathe our air. You make us your friend, and that is your moon too. And you can damn well help us when we need it.
I was helping.
What, by clearing off?
Yes.
Yeah, well, clear off. Go on. You can clear off. Get back in your lonely bloody TARDIS, and you don't come back.
Yeah. So.
Clara.
He obviously did not expect this.
You go away. Okay.
It is because the stakes were so high. If he stayed there, if he was like, okay, the decision is yours, I'm not going to be a part of it, but he stayed there as a comfort, she would have been probably more okay with turning off the device, you know? She would have been more okay with it. But the fact that he completely left, he did abandon them, and honestly left them to the possibility of dying. That was a little much for her. You do understand that, because the stakes were so high. It wasn't exactly like with the Silurian conference, where it was a conference. Yes, there were problems and there were things that need to be addressed, but all in all, it wasn't as dramatic as this. So while you understand what the doctor did, flat out leaving them was the problem. So I do understand that. I understand where Clara's coming from on that and why it's just too much for her. So I'm going to go. I like Danny being the council.
Danny, what do you think?
I think I've seen this look before.
No, you haven't. This is new for me.
Yeah, not on your face, on mine.
Yeah.
What did you do?
I left the army.
You loved the army.
Yep. I mean, one day I didn't.
Yeah.
I'm done. I am finished with it. I'm done. It's over. I'm finished with him, and I told him that. What is that face for? Why don't you believe me?
Because you're still angry. With anyone, Mom, it can still make you angry. Tell me when you're calm, then tell me.
Yeah. When you calm down, are you going to change your... Are you still going to be set with this?
Same way as anyone else. I had a really bad day.
Yeah. So this plays into, you know, him. What happened with him. Because, you know, he said last episode, if he ever pushes you too far, you have to tell me, because I've been down that road. And this is it. He knows what to say to her because he's been down this road where he was pushed too far in the army. And I like him saying, you know, tell him when you're calm and then tell me, you know? And yeah, it's like, if once she calms down, will she get back with the doctor? I obviously think so, because it's the middle of the season. But it would be interesting if that was the basis of the next episode. Maybe we have a companion light episode. Honestly, it would be interesting if we had two plot lines going on next episode, where one of the plot lines was Clara on Earth, you know, trying to make the decision and eventually going back to the doctor, and the other is the doctor on his own and then eventually going back to Clara. That could be really interesting, but we'll have to see. But yeah, I think this was a really, really great episode. Really, really great. And one of the most interesting, too. You know, just one of the most captivating episodes. I really, really enjoyed it, and I'm curious to see where we are going next time. So yeah, that is pretty much it. With all that being said, I'm Alex from 7th Hour Films, and I will see you guys next time. Take care. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video. If you want to watch more of my Doctor Who reactions, you can click on the playlist, you can subscribe if you haven't done that already, and be sure you hit that notification bell. You can support me on Patreon and follow me on social media, links below in the description. See you guys later.